What is a business without a website nowadays? Just an initiative, I believe. But don't throw rotten tomatoes at me just yet. Instead, let's run through the main tricks of creating an A-class website and see why social media will never replace the website. Let's get into it. As unbelievable as it is, just a little over a year ago, study revealed that 23% of small retail businesses don't have a website. And 1/3 of those businesses said they never needed a website. Excuse me, what? You never needed a website? Even during the pandemic? As you see from the graph, another reason for having no website is getting by social media. Guys, social media is not enough. It does help you promote your store and raise awareness about your brand, but it doesn't do a website's job. A website allows you to set up the lead generation routine, collecting email addresses or phone numbers for further marketing. You can't always do that through your social media. To cut it short, you need a website anyway, or at least a landing page. Don't know which one you need? No worries, we got that covered in one of my previous videos. The link in the description section below. And while we're here, I urge you to subscribe to this channel to stay in the know of our new videos. Thanks, you're the best. So, what is an easy-to-go strategy for creating a website? Use SendPulse. I'm not kidding, guys. SendPulse provides no-code solutions for website building. Just choose a template, use the drag-and-drop editor to tailor it to your business, and you're good to go. Use SendPulse to build your free website without coding. And once you have the website, make sure to take 4 steps while developing it. Step 1. Create eye-catchy content. I feel I've said this a million times in my videos yet anyway. Remember, your website visitors want to have a good experience while walking around your site. Give them such a chance by listing your core benefits and values through headings or bullet points. Provide tips on how to use your product or services through your blog. Don't forget the use cases to kind of say, hey, we have clients, they used our products, and here's their feedback, so you can trust us too. Don't scare away with a ton of text. Include the imagery and videos. This way you can introduce your team, show how your products work, how your team works, anything that will engage the reader and show you are real. However, don't overdo it. You don't want to hurt your website's load speed. Optimize your images and always use web and mobile-friendly formats. Step 2. Think of lead generation. This is a crucial way to make your website worth your time and effort and work for you. When users visit your website, make sure they leave a trace in your mailing list or phone book. This way, you will be able to catch up with them later, bringing you special offers. What's the best way to generate leads and grow your mailing list? Use pop-ups to gather first-time visitors' email addresses. Or if the user reaches out during your business hours, use a live chat to grab their email or number, contact them later, and resolve the issue. SendPulse provides pop-up and chatbot functionality for free. You just need to try it out and see for yourself. In one of my previous videos, I talked about pop-up mistakes you must avoid. Make sure you check it out. Step 3. Pay attention to SEO. No matter how hard everyone tries to bury SEO under the GPT-3 success, I am big on SEO. Align your content to SEO requirements. Use the right amount of keywords naturally in the right places to help your content get found quicker. Never, just never neglect filling in the metadata. This way, Google crawlers quickly estimate your site's value while scanning it. Work on backlinks. Write guest blogs, reviews, be active on Quora, and create shareable content. Together with that, run A/B tests and track the effectiveness of your SEO strategy through various metrics. Finally, step 4. Make your website easy to navigate. You want your visitors to have the best experience while using your website. Do them a favor, make your website user-friendly. Declutter the welcome page by creating separate pages for each product, service, or topic. Bind the pages by CTAs and experiment with your website design. You may need prior A/B testing to see which layout, site, menu, and CTA text work better. And that's a wrap for today, guys. What do you think of this strategy? Did you take any of these steps while building your website? Let me know and I will see you in the next one. Bye!